Throughout the world, animals have evolved some truly remarkable defense mechanisms.
Caterpillars that mimic vipers. Squids that emit bursts of light. Birds that vomit oil. And one of the coolest are the masters of chemical warfare.
These invertebrates spray their attackers with acid.
All around us are the products of modern chemistry.
I took acid, and it just blew my mind.
Fill an enema bag with the prepared baking soda solution.
Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Animalogic Second Nature. The most famous acidic species are the aptly named Bombardier beetles.
These carabid, or ground beetles, devastate their attackers by shooting boiling chemicals out of their abdomen. There are about 500 species of ground beetle with this superpower, and they're found on every continent except Antarctica.
As beetles, they fall prey to a wide array of predators. Ants, birds, lizards, your cat Mr. Mittens. And so, they evolved a very complex defense system that sends a clear message. Back off.
Today, chemicals are available which will kill insects weeks after they're applied.
To achieve this explosive effect, bombardier beetles have two separate compartments in their abdomens. The first one contains a solution of hydrogen peroxide and hydroquinones. At the first sight of danger, a valve opens, and said solution moves to the second compartment. The second compartment is a reaction chamber full of catalysts. The chemical reaction that takes place in this chamber creates chemicals called quinones. This chemical is caustic enough to burn predators, and the reaction is so strong that it sounds like a mini explosion.
Duck and cover. That flash means act fast.
But its burn isn't just a chemical one.
The reaction also creates a lot of heat. When the bombardier beetle releases its chemicals, they're 100 degrees Celsius. Because of the temperature, it quickly evaporates, giving the impression that the insect is shooting hot mist. Not only do they use their acid to ward off predators at a distance, but when swallowed by frogs, they'll let loose the acid, causing the frog to puke them up. They cause the worst stomach aches of all time.
And down he spins. And he spins into a situation where he is virtually buried alive in a chemical tomb.
At first sight, it looks like a constant stream, but really, they're pulsating very quickly, peaking at 500 pulses per second.
A part of the explosion chamber actually deforms during the explosion, and when it does so, it cuts off the flow of reactants into the explosion chamber. And so that causes the explosion to temporarily stop.
Several species can also bend the tip of their abdomen, allowing it to function much like a turret. They can target predators with great accuracy, often warding off attacking ants in all directions. They can't sustain the spray for very long, but a quick blast gives them enough time to unfurl their wings and fly away.
One common defense that many invertebrates use is smelling and tasting terrible.
Honey, your coffee just doesn't taste any good.
This usually comes from hydroquinones, which are naturally stinky. And these species store them in order to ward off predators.
Many walking stick species produce noxious chemicals so that they taste awful. But there is one genus of walking stick that takes it a step further.
The southern walking stick shoots a stinky, thick, milky fluid out of two holes in its thorax. This potent spray can blind an attacking lizard, giving the stick bug time to escape. The smell of the spray is so bad that they are also called devil riders and musk mares.
The glands are located behind their head and are active at birth. Nymphs have even been seen using them to ward off attacking ants.
Many species of ant are equipped with stingers and venom, a formic acid, to deal with attackers.
Incidentally, they inject a little formic acid into their victims, and that helps to stupefy them.
But there are a few species that don't need to get up close to use their defense. These ants shoot acid.
In these species, their acid is stored in a sac, and it can be up to 20% of the ant's weight.
The redwood ant is the most notorious acid-spewing ant species.
They live in colonies of almost 500,000 acidic ants. When they're approached by a predator, or something they consider to be threatening, they shoot it with acid. It's quite a spectacle to behold. Thousands of ants simultaneously filling the air with formic acid.
Though not all would-be attackers are deterred, and some have no intention of attacking, some birds have learned that a chemical bath is a great way to get rid of parasites.
And so, they harass the wood ants in order to be doused with formic acid. Their acid kills off any ticks, mites, fungi, or bacteria that may be living on them.
A real acid trip, you know, is like, you know, you just have to get your mind blown.
And finally, we come to the coolest of the acid sprayers, the Vinegaroon.
These arachnids, also known as whip scorpions, unlike many other arachnids, lack venom or any real way of defending themselves beyond pincers. And so, they shoot a combination of acetic and caprylic acid.
And it happens to smell like vinegar, hence the name.
Clear, sparkling, and aromatic, and uniform.
Though despite the smell, their acid is actually 10 to 20 times more acidic than vinegar.
When threatened, Vinegaroons jettison their acid from two turrets located on either side of their whip. They can aim their spray fairly well, as their whip has good mobility.
Can both of you add me as a fan? Oh, I just got sprayed.
Ah, I smell it. Oh, oh my god. Oh, speaking of which,
wow.
How irritating is that? Oh,
it is spray. Irritating. Let me go wash my face. Oh my god.
If a Vinegaroon were to spray your skin, it wouldn't hurt very much. But if it were to spray your eyes or any other soft tissue, you'd be in for a world of pain.
Their spray is much more effective against any insects that may be predating upon them. Their caprylic acid damages the attacking insect's protective waxy cuticle, leaving them more vulnerable to acetic acid burns.
While you're still here, we want to learn a little bit more about you and what you're interested in. So we put together a short survey, and if you fill it out, you're going to help us shape Animalogic for 2020. One lucky fan will win an Animalogic prize pack with a signed poster, an art book, and a sticker pack from our upcoming merch store. Please just click the link in the description. It'll only take a couple minutes, I promise. Thank you. Now back to you, past Danielle. So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for new episodes of Animalogic Second Nature every other week. Thanks for watching.
Starting to see lightning flashes out of the corner of my eye. That's a sign that I'm really loaded.